Johan Dennelin, CEO of Digi.com, joins us for an exclusive from beautiful Kuala Lumpur. Johan, good morning. Sir, you must all be excited about selling this 3GS and whatever other iPhones you're planning to enable your customers with. What's the impact going to be on the company?
Good morning to you, Bernie. Well, yes, we are very excited to be able to break that news today on your show. We bring it in during this first half year, and they're going to be perfect match for our internet propositions that we're now taking to the market with our new network. So it's going to be exciting.
How much are you going to invest in it, and what will the any idea what the forecast impact will be on the top and bottom lines?
Well, it's one component of our propositions, obviously, but it's going to be an important piece now during the internet boom. The market is actually exploding as we speak, both in terms of big screen broadband, but also in the small screen experience. And apparently and obviously, iPhone has taken off and now also been educated well for 9 months in the market. So we believe it's the right time to come in, and we're glad that we secure that opportunity today.
The fact that you're not the first with the iPhone, Max's was first. Do you feel like you're going to be going to have your work cut out trying to close the gap and playing runner-up, if you will?
Well, not necessarily. I think they have been able to capture some of the early adopters, but I think the mainstream is coming in now, and therefore we believe it's the right time to come in. And we're also investing heavily this year in the 3G network and in the turbo 3G network that we have. So one more device and one more opportunity for people to experience this, on top of the other things, of course. We have a suite of propositions with also BlackBerries and high-speed broadband to the homes. So this is going to be an exciting year for when internet actually comes to mainstream in Malaysia, which it hasn't done yet. So it's a good timing.
Tell me a little bit about how business is going, Johan. Profits were down in the last completed quarter. Revenues, I mean, it's a very, very competitive landscape which you're up against in the mobile space. What is the outlook for this year? And presumably, this is why you're doing things like the iPhone, because you've done the homework, you've done the research, and you figure, hey, this could only be icing on the cake.
Well, first of all, Bernie, last year was a very tough year for us all. I think we managed to come through that year with a great fighting spirit and coming out with growth and growing faster than one of them, but slower than the other one. So we used the year last year also to reposition the company to be able to take part of this year's growth when we see the growth coming back. The growth this year is at least in the mid-teens, and we always aim to overperform the industry, which we have done for the past 5 years to both of the operators, with one exception, and that was one of them last year. So we're pretty optimistic about 2010.
Are you going to need to externally fund the rollout of the iPhone, or do you have more cash in the bank than you know what to do with?
Not iPhone specifically. It's not that a major commitment that you need to fund one specific thing. But definitely we are prepared to invest heavily in the data growth. And our capex this year is at least 700 million ringgit. But we don't cap it at that. We're prepared to invest now in the growth that is coming. With regards to external funding, we have just raised some funds. And we are pretty well balanced on that side now. But we're not afraid, or the balance sheet allows for more gearing, if you wish. And we've also said that this year is the year where we'll find an optimal balance sheet. So also, again, coming back to our capital management story, which has been a key part of the Digi stock, where we have returned 5.8 billion ringgit over the past 5 years, we aim to be an attractive yield stock also going into the future. And there you can see components of the restructuring of the balance sheet, or optimizing the balance sheet.
Johan, congratulations on the iPhone move. I know a lot of your customers out there, especially the 20 and 30-somethings, are going to love you for it.